the starting thought as you go into this is that you're flipping over your own shoulders. So I've got this dotted line drawn at relatively shoulder height, and our stick figure is jumping up to higher than their own shoulders. Hips elevate over the shoulders, which are a fixed point. They continue rotating at that same height, and then they land. So we've got a ton of jumping and a little bit of air sense to find yourself back to the ground before anybody even thinks about flipping over. So there have been videos made that say that if you can power clean your own body weight, you can do a backflip. I think that's true in terms of speed and power. I don't necessarily agree that power cleaning your own body weight gives you the air sense to do a backflip. I don't think that those two have anything to do with each other. So I want to talk a little bit about landing, a little bit about flipping, talk about air sense, and if you can power clean your own body weight, that would be an added bonus. So here's what's going on. You're standing on the box backwards, you're swinging your arms up as you go to jump, you are seeing the ground come around right as you land in a nice quarter squat. What? Power clean? Crazy. Do one, and you tap. One more time through the boxes with the landing. One more time through the rings. Good, good. I want there to be an arm swing ball. So your arms go down and then up and they stop really hard. Yes, yes, right. Okay, good. Think about the fact that your hips are rising over your shoulders when you hang on those rings. This is giving you that fixed point in the diagram. Yep, hips up and over. On it if it's starting to make sense. Good, find that's way better. Keep standing. You want to be in the same quarter squat that you're in off the box. So obviously, to buy yourself enough time in the air to flip over, you've got to have a pretty serious jump. That's where that ability to power clean your own body weight comes in. It means you can really move some weight through your hip. You're trying to get the exact same power from your hip to do a backflip. It's just your own body weight that you're trying to move. So what I'm looking for, with your back to the wall, I'm looking for you to go for a nice high jump and let your feet lift up just a little bit. So if I jump and let my feet go, you can see that this isn't really a very powerful position. You want to be jumping and trying to get your feet to come up in front of you just a little bit. Check it out. You can go two at a time. We do a lot of hollow holds. That was a good fender. See if you can find that hollow body position. That's it. You gotta jump a little higher than that, you two. Nice, Daniel. Oh, that's funny what a difference it makes. Yeah, so both of these guys, if you look at them, you can see their hips come up. So now it makes sense, if their shoulders are fixed height, that they can rotate around that. That's okay, so now, here's the deal. So you know how on a kipping pull-up, it's not height. It's not just pick your legs up, relax your butt, it's squeeze your butt. Can you picture the front of a kipping pull-up? I want you in the same shape. Stop your legs, squeeze your butt. Yeah, good, rest. Stop all your head. All right, let's go over to the pose. So in terms of creating rotation, some people flip and some people don't. I don't have a rhyme or a reason or a length of your legs that really matters. But the thing to think about is that if your hips rise, you're buying yourself time in the air. So against this post, I'm looking for you to go hips up then pull your knees into your face. If you leave your hips on the ground and tuck, you're not gonna flip over. You're gonna feel this difference. You're realizing that's not rotation. You're going hips up, curling a little ball, and it wants to just pull you right over. Grab a post, check it out. Really go up into that candlestick position that we talked about. Yep, hips up. And now do one where you leave your tailbone on the ground and just tuck your knees up to your belly. And you're gonna see that you just don't flip over in the same way. If you don't elevate your hips, there's nothing rotating you over. Sweet, really good. And obviously a smaller ball flips faster. Okay, downside of this drill, you have to sit down to do it, which totally doesn't go with my stick figure that goes up over their shoulders. If I could make this shoulder height, it would be a better illustration, but it works for now. You're going hands slightly a bit higher than your head, you're rolling back, your hips are popping up, you're rolling over and trying to land in a bear crawl type position. Fender, show us how fast you flip. He gets over the small ball, it's impressive. Think about that bear crawl position, it's just more comfortable. And the carpet foam off that ball and just kind of set over by the stairs. You are going to lie back with your head hanging off the edge. Your arms are pushing down to give you a little bit of rotation. You're thinking about lifting your hips up. You're seeing the ground right at the last minute and you're landing on your feet. Great. I pulled in pretty well. I like that. Good. Okay, yep. Push, nice. Great, okay. Next, totally perfect moment. You fell really well. If you've like snowboarded or skateboarded or been at all active, you hopefully know this, or had that unfortunate friend that fell off the monkey bars as a kid. If you're falling back and you go to catch yourself, that's your most potential for injury. Then flat out missing is you go collarbone or elbow or shoulder or something. Payam did it great. He fell back and he just went on his butt. This thing is nice and soft. If you're falling, don't put your hands behind you. It sounds really stupid to have to tell you that, but it takes months. So the first skill is just to jump up as high as you can, try to land on your butt with your arms up for now. Go ahead. Don't do any of the other pieces. Just jump up and see it with your arms up. Great. You kicked his feet up in front of him just a little bit. Yeah, the mat's are perfectly sized. Take a turn there, now come over here and jump off this thing. And you want to stay this way a little. All right, who's going here? Daniel, Elliot, you're on. Matt Nix is going for it. Keep them through these drills. Really nice, Elliot, good job. Jump up to a seated position. He's gonna have to shimmy himself up to the front half. If you're a little bit taller, it matters more because it's not fun when you miss. And then he's gonna do a backward roll down this wedge mat lima. Two in two pieces. Yep, he's gonna shimmy four. Okay, I would rather you do the backward roll with your hands here. Cool, pop on over this drill. That was it, that's perfect. Next little victim. Yep, hands up. Push. Thanks, Matt Nix. No problem. And then jump on over to this drum. Great hard stop roll there. Yep. Sit your hands. Nice, Elliot. Side of the road. Throw your feet over. Nice. High on that roll is no problem. So now, Fender's going to put it all together. He's going to jump up. He's going to land. He's going to roll back. If he lands, forget that, on his butt, it's not authentic. It's not that jump up and over your shoulders piece. So he's going to try basically to jump to the candlestick position that you found caused rotation, and then just pull his hips right over. Skip your butt is what I'm trying to say in a lot of words. Yeah, try to. Big jump, hips up. Yeah, I think you leave your arms down, so you can get him to come up a little longer. That makes it so good! I want you to pick your feet up sooner, Elliot. That was too delayed. You would need a hell of a lot of jump. You'd be skydiving from space for that to work. Yep, and up. Hey, nice! stand there after you see this drill and make sense, can you kind of picture the order of operations? Are you confident with the idea of flipping over? Or did you have this one accident once when you were 10 and this like totally sketches you out and it's not an option at all? It really matters. Like, your psychology about doing this, I am yet to find someone that thinks that they can do a backflip and is 100% wrong. Like, there's a stopping point when it gets to going upside down and having the potential to break your neck. Most people that are completely sober and mentally sound know better. Most. I didn't say it was a good idea. Help or no help on the first one? You fine? Better jump hard. Don't stand up. Nice and aggressive on the jump. Whoops.
Was that the first time?
No, I've done a couple of these before.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I've done them on, like, diving boards and skis and stuff, but never just on flat ground, so.
Okay.
Could you show me how you spot?
Yeah. Let me get Fender. So, basically, don't do anything yet until I'm grabbing you. I am trying to maintain his height. If his hips come much lower than this, he's kind of in a bad way in that moment. I'm keeping a little bit of height. I've got my hands spun so I can basically rotate him. All I can really do, if you totally screw up, is hope to get you past your head, because you are way
so
bigger
you
than
land I am. On your belly or something like that.
You would end up going like hands and knees, basically.
Yeah.
Don't think about that, but that's realistically what happened. Good. Thanks.
I'm curious about trying it. I don't think I want to do it during the workouts.
Okay. What's your experience flipping?
I mean, I can backflip off of, like, bridges. You know, I can backflip off of, like, I think I've actually, well, no, I guess I haven't done anything other than into water, so.
Okay. Stand there. You're not going to do it. I want
sure.
you to picture what's going to happen. Do you have some concept of what you need to do and know where the ground is? Can you visualize what's gonna go on?
I think I have the momentum. I mean, I think so.
Have a feel.
I think okay. so. I'm actually worried about over-rotating.
Oh, I'm not. Go do one more drill where Desmond is.
Another one of these?
Yeah. Just feel it.
Yeah.
Fine. You probably don't need it. That looks good, Matt. Okay. Matt Nix, you're committed.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah, yeah. With the spot?
Not all of you.
Okay, so you grab the gear. Yep. All right. Whoa. Job! Nicely done!
That didn't feel so bad.
That wasn't so bad.
Yeah.
I
actually have a feeling I'm going to probably keep
yeah.
landing.
You probably are going to keep doing it. It was a
I almost
wild.
Feel more comfortable going all the way down onto yeah. all fours.
So this jittery feeling mm-hmm. will subside in about a minute. You'll catch your breath. You'll stop shaking. You'll do another one. It'll be way better.
Yeah.